Well, there's new hope for 400,000 Australians struck down by stroke each year. Revolutionary treatment is minimising disabilities and slashing the recovery time. As Tegan George reports now, it's saving millions of dollars in hospital care and rehab.
John Radhai doesn't remember his stroke. One minute he wasn't feeling well, the next day he woke up in hospital.
My right leg was a little bit weak and I could walk, but not very well. But my right arm was just like a dead weight.
It was brought on by a heart attack, but John was lucky. He was treated in a specialised stroke unit where doctors used new technology to pinpoint the clot and then dissolve it.
Those acute therapies can sometimes reverse a stroke quite spectacularly, in which case patients often can return closer to what they were normally like.
This is what John's brain would have looked like if the stroke had been left to progress. The red dots showing areas with abnormal blood flow. The small mark highlighted in this photo shows where the stroke actually formed. Every 10 minutes in Australia, someone has a stroke. It's now the leading cause of disability, with the financial burden estimated to be around $5 billion a year. The specialist units aim to slash that burden by working on patients as soon as possible.
In the early hours after a stroke, there are a number of complications that can occur and are preventable.
The early intervention helps reduce the severity of disabilities.
We're allowed to go in and interact with the patients about a day after they've had their lysis, and that gets us getting them going as quick as possible.
And that also helps cut rehab time.
I can't feel the tips of my fingers, and that's about the only thing that's wrong now. So, it's a blessing or something. It's just amazing.
If it wasn't for them, he wouldn't be here. So, everyone is just fantastic. Yeah.